हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टुडे, वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विद द चैप्टर सोशलिज्म इन यूरोप एंड द रशियन रेवोल्यूशन। एंड इन द लास्ट वीडियो व्हाट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड, वी हैव सीन द इकोनॉमिक कंडीशन ऑफ रशियन सोसाइटी, वी हैव सीन द इकोनॉमिक कंडीशन ऑफ रशियन सोसाइटी। एंड टुडे वी विल सी द रशियन सोसाइटी। How was the Russian society? Right. So, what was there in the Russian society? First, we'll talk about the cities, then we'll discuss about the rural area. First, we'll talk about the cities, then we'll discuss about the rural area. Right. Number one, what was there that workers migrated from villages and settled in cities, and they were divided by skills. What were there? Workers were migrating from the villages and they were settling in the cities. Why they were migrating from the villages? Reason was there because most of the land, most of the property was owned by nobility, crown and church. So they have to do the work for them. That's why what they were doing, they were migrating to the cities. What were they doing? They were migrating to the cities and they were divided by skills. Workers were divided by skills. Skills means, suppose the metal workers, they were at the top, and the industries like textile and wool industry, they were considered as inferior. Right. So what was there? Because for the steel and iron work, there was need of more skill. That's why, for example, metal workers considered themselves as aristocrats among the other workers. Aristocrat means rich. What they were thinking, they were considering themselves aristocrat. Who? Metal workers. Those who were working at St. Petersburg or the Moscow. Those who were working in the St. Petersburg or in the Moscow, in the industries, what these people were thinking, the workers of these industries were thinking that they are aristocrat among the other workers because they were having the more skill as comparison to the other workers. And what next was there? Women made up 31% of the factory labor force. What was there? Women made up 31%, means whatever the total force was there, out of that 31% force was of women. What was there? 31% force was of women, labor force. But what was there? They were paid less than men. They were paid less than men. Reason was there why they were paid less than men, that what was there? Why they were paying less than men? Because they were considered, the society was like that, the women are inferior to men. Women are inferior to men. They are not having that much capacity or capability that a man is having. So what was there? If they were doing the same work, whether they were doing the same work, but the men were getting more wages as comparison to the women. And next, no doubt division was there. Division was there on the basis of their skills. But workers did unite to strike. But whenever they wanted to strike against the employer or against whomsoever, what were they doing? They were unite. The all workers were unite. No doubt division was there. But the workers did unite to strike. Whenever they want to do the strike, whether it's for the textile, whether for the, in the wool industry or in the metal workers industry. So what was there? Whenever they wanted to do the strike, they all were unite. Against the employer on the dismissal of their demand and working condition. When the employers, what they were doing, they were not accepting the demands of the workers. Right, what kind of demands? That less working hours or more wages. Or if they were not paying attention on the working condition of the workers, then what were they doing? They were doing the strikes. And in the strikes, all workers were unite. Example, strikes in textile industry in 1897 and metal industry during 1902. In these industries, strikes were there. Right, so what was there during this strike? All the workers took part. Means they all stopped doing work for the factory. This was the condition in the Russian society and Russian cities. Now there is example of the society in the countryside. Countryside means in the villages. Peasants cultivated most of the land. I told you what was there. Most of the people were peasants. Most of the people were peasants in the Russia, and 80% people were doing the cultivation. But most of property owned by nobility, the crown and the church. What was there? Most of the land was under the control of nobility, church and crown. So what was there? The peasants has to do the work on the land of nobility, crown and church. So what was there? Why they raised their demand and why they did strike, did revolution for the against the nobility, church and the crown? Because most of the land was controlled by these people, these nobility, crown and church. And whatever the work was done by the peasants or the workers, whatever the profits were kept by the factory owner. They were not paying any attention towards the condition of the workers. Right, towards the condition of the workers. Like workers, peasants were also divided. What was there? That peasants were also divided like workers. Like peasants are divided on the basis of skill, and peasants were divided on the basis of their land or property. The peasants who were having some land or property, what were they doing? They were considering themselves as superior as comparison to the other or the landless peasant. So what was there in Russia? Except in a few cases, peasants had no respect for the nobility. Right. What was there? Peasants in Russia, they were not giving respect to the nobility. On the other hand, they wanted to occupy the land of the nobles. Whatever the land is with the noble, they want to control that land. Unlike it was observed during the French Revolution. In France, what was there? The peasants respected nobles and fought for them. In France, what was there? That the peasants, they were giving respect to the nobles. But in Russia, the case was opposite. They were not giving any respect to the nobility because Russian peasants wanted the lands of the nobles. What they want? They wanted the lands of the nobles. They do not want to give the respect, or they were not giving the respect, but they, on the other hand, they want their land. And the Russian peasants were different from the other European peasants. Like other European peasants, what they were doing the means cultivation for their own land, on their own land for their own benefit. But in Russia, it was different. What they did? They worked by pooling their land together. What were they doing? They were collecting the land, collectivization of land. Collecting the land means whatsoever person is having land, they were merging their lands with the others, and collectively they were doing the land, work on the land. Collectively, they were doing work on the land, and whatever the outcome was coming. Whatever the produce was coming, then they were dividing the output according to the needs of a individual. Means whosoever is in need, and they can take that thing. Right. So it was the concept of that Karl Marx, that equal society, everyone will work together and will get the equal share, means equal share means according to their need, and what will be there, that nobody will lag behind. So this was their our economy and society. This was unit 2.2, and in the next video we will do the unit 2.3. Right, so till then, stay at home and revise the questions or make the questions, extra questions thoroughly. Right, okay, thank you.